TP kids, we always try to teach new ways and new things to draw for our children. Because some children think it's difficult to draw. And we teach them to draw with very simple methods. We drew animals, we drew fruits. Did we draw a lot of fruits? Did you see us draw a lot of fruits on our YouTube channel?
We drew only a few fruits.
Only a few fruits. Okay, so then why not draw another fruit today? Is there any fruit that you like to draw?
I know there must be a lot of fruits.
But is there anything in particular?
Actually, I like oranges, apples, pears, wood apples, grapes.
Mangoes.
I like mangoes
Even
too.
I like mangoes. We have to encourage our kids to eat all these natural fruits because sometimes they use chemicals and that's very bad for us. So you have to always try to grow fruits at home so that you know it's organic. And that's the safest way to do it. Now if there are any parents watching, you must make sure that you give your children only organic, healthy fruits. Because that's what's good for us. Parents, that's your responsibility. So now when we're drawing fruits, it's always a little easy to draw big fruits like an apple. But when we want to draw small fruits, maybe something like grapes, kids find it difficult. So today we thought we'll draw a bunch of grapes. It won't be so difficult. I'll teach you, okay?
Okay.
Minuti, do you know any stories about grapes? Any stories that you've heard in the past? Who said that grapes were sour?
Fox.
Do you know the story with the fox and the grapes? Do you know it?
Yes.
Can you tell us about that story about the grapes being sour?
Once upon a time, there was a fox. On his way home, saw a vine trained along the branches of a tree. A bunch of ripe grapes hanging on a tree.
Ripe grapes.
So the fox had to jump really high to catch the grapes.
Because the grapes were so high, the fox jumped and jumped and jumped, but he couldn't catch it and he got angry. And then what did he do? You know, because the fox couldn't catch it, he said that the grapes were sour and he just walked away. He would have been so hungry. Lot of people give up when things are difficult, but we have to have a positive attitude and we must always think that we can do things. So let's draw a bunch of grapes today. Let's not make them sour. Let's make them ripe. And today we are going to use the pencil as well to draw. Okay, so here's your pencil. We are going to use the pencil today because sometimes when we draw things and we have to draw over them again and again, it's difficult to get that 3D effect. So it'll be easier to draw these grapes with the pencil. Okay, then we are going to start drawing now. Okay,
okay, let's
high five.
Draw.
All right. So as I told you before, we are going to start drawing the grapes with the pencil. Okay, so now look at what I'm doing. We can draw a small circle like this. Okay, nice. Now let's draw another circle overlapping the first circle, like this. Okay, so now draw another circle like that where it crosses the line. It's overlapping. Nice, Minudi. Okay, so we have to draw more circles now because there will be more grapes in this bunch. So let's draw a circle here, like that. Okay, so now we are going to draw another circle, just like this. It's overlapping two circles. Okay, so now the next one, we'll just draw one circle at the end because have you seen in a bunch of grapes, it gets narrow at the end,
yes.
Right? So we will draw one more circle like this over the other lines as well. Nice. Okay, so now we'll take the marker and we will start tracing over some of the grapes. We'll first start with this grape. Okay, so slowly you trace over the pencil mark and you draw the full grape like this. Okay. Now tell me if it's difficult, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so now you can see this grape that it's covered, right? So you only draw the part that you can see. Don't draw the covered part. Right, like that, and a little bit more. Yeah, till this point. Okay, so now let's go to this grape. And even in this grape, you do the same thing. So you don't draw the part that's covered so that it looks like it's behind that first grape. Okay, so let's go to the next grape. Watch me. You can draw this part. And also, you can draw a bit of the rest of it so that you can see that it's behind the other grape. So this part will be a new grape. It won't be a part of the grape that we just drew now. So now let's draw this grape, only this part, and then finally you draw the last grape. Now you can see the bunch nicely.
Yes.
Okay, so now we can, shall we draw some little faces in these grapes, you know, so that it'll be nicer? We can draw like two eyes like this. And we can draw the mouth. Which way should we draw the mouth? Shall we draw the mouth open? Actually, you know what? We can draw different faces for all the grapes. Maybe this one, it won't be open. Yes, we are going to draw the leaf. We are definitely going to draw the leaf. So, you like drawing different faces, right? Like this. Okay, so we can draw different faces. This one looks a bit sad and angry. We'll have to draw a face that is smiling also. No, like this, a very happy one. Also, we can draw a very funny face.
Also, a crying face.
Ah, okay, so let's make this a sad face like this. The last one can be like a moody face, like this. A bit angry and a bit moody. Okay. Okay, so just like you said before, we are going to add a stem to this bunch of grapes, like this. We can add a stem from this grape as well, connecting the two stems. And of course, what about this grape? We'll add a stem here as well. Okay, so we can draw the leaf now in this kind of a small zigzag kind of way. That's how the grape leaf is, right? And we can draw another leaf on this side. See, I drew the line in the middle first, and now I'm drawing the leaf like this. Okay, so we have drawn a bunch of grapes. So now all we have to do is color it. Okay, now see if you can choose purple out of all those colors.
Uncle,
yeah?
I have seen 3 colors of grapes.
Okay, what were those colors?
One is dark red,
Okay. Other
one light green, and there's another one purple.
That's actually a very good observation. There are different colored grapes, but most commonly, we always see the purple colored grapes. So we'll draw these grapes in purple so that it'll be easy for small kids to identify.
Yes.
We will draw a bunch of green grapes later, maybe in another episode, okay? Because you know, there are many ways of drawing grapes. We will explore different ways of drawing the same fruit in a different episode. But today, we will color the grapes in purple. Are you okay with that?
Okay.
Okay, so then let's start coloring the grapes in purple.
Uncle?
Yeah?
What about these pencil lines?
It's okay, don't worry. You can cover the pencil lines. Earlier, we used the pencil to get the sketch of the grapes. Now don't worry about it. Okay, so now we are done with that. So now we can use the green to color the leaves and the stem.
Uncle, yeah? Shall we color these leaves in dark green?
Yeah, sure. We'll color the stem in this color and then we'll color the leaves in a darker green. No, first use the light green to color the leaves and then see. I'll show you what I'm going to do. Later we are going to color it again with a darker green. So now we take the dark green and we color this line like this. And then we can shape the leaf like this so that it looks more natural. Okay, are you done? Shall we color this mouth in red? Let me see. Okay, wait, I'll color this and I'll give it to you. Like this. That's better, right? Okay, so we have completed drawing a nice bunch of grapes, a juicy bunch of grapes. Our program DP Kids promotes new ways for kids to look at things so that they're creative. Shall we show them?
Okay.
So this is what we drew today. Purple grapes that look very tasty. We will continue to draw new things like this in our future programs as well. So you have to keep watching DP Kids. Shall we remind them how they can watch DP Kids?
Browse our YouTube channel, check out our videos, subscribe us and click the bell button. If you like our videos and if you have any suggestions, don't forget to comment too.
Yes, you should comment because we will take your comments into account when we are planning our future programs. We hope that there'll be a lot more kids watching our programs in the future. But sadly, it's time for us to say goodbye today.
Okay.
Okay, everyone. Good luck.
Good luck.